Spear Magic Helmet. Spear Magic Helmet, that's right. Spear Magic Helmet. YouTube, it's your boy Rook here, and I wanted to go on a new toy hunt because of the hot cash that's coming out for today for Hot Topics. So I decided to take a look at their pop wall, and this is what we had on the pop wall. I want you guys to see kind of what they have here on the pop wall. A lot of good stuff here, but this is what I'm really focusing on these four right here. That's right, guys, the Looney Tunes stuff. That's right. Let me get the stuff here so I get my camera. The Elmer Fudd from Looney Tunes. I love me some old Bugs Bunny. I love me some Looney Tunes. Spear Magic Helmet. Spear Magic Helmet, that's right, Spear Magic Helmet. I had to get the actual Elmer Fudd one, and you can't have Elmer Fudd, which is playing the opera with the Spear Magic Helmet gag, unless you had the Boomhilda, the Bugs Bunny as well. So I'm getting both of these pops, definitely. Now, I saw the Bugs and Daffy. I have to get me some Bugs and Daffy love. You guys know I like Looney Tunes. I mentioned it already. I mentioned it in prior videos. I have to get me some Bugs Bunny. But you got to have his antagonist. You got to have Daffy Duck. You got to get them both to complete at least this portion of the wave. Now, I saw the, of course, I showed it real quick on the actual shot here for you. Let me get back into this frame. Well, there we go, right there. And I saw the Sylvester and Tweety. I'm not really sold on them. Let me know in the comment section, should I actually pick up this one as well? I don't know. And they had Taz. I don't know if I want to complete the entire wave or not. Let me know in the comment section, should I get the Taz? Or more importantly, should I get the Sylvester and Tweety? But I'm very, very, very excited and very happy to get all four of the Looney Tunes. We have, of course, the opera, Bugs and Elmer, and of course, we have the normal Bugs and Daffy in the standard versions. I'm very, very happy to get all these into my collection. All
right, guys, the hunt for today is complete. It was a very quick hunt. I only hit one place, in this case, Hot Topics. I had to blow through my hot cash, or it would have expired in another week or so, and I wanted to use it. It was about $15 off a $30 purchase or more. We're looking at four pops, which I picked up at the beginning of this particular video, and they were going for about $12.50 each. I saved about $12.50, give or take or so, for these particular items. It came out to about $40 for all four of these pops. If you think about it, it saved about $3 a pop, so it's about the price of a pop itself. So I'm a big fan, as I mentioned in my other videos, of Looney Tunes, the old school cartoon, the old school animation style, original pencil and animation style, not computer driven, not like what you see today. We're talking old school Merry Melodies cartoons from the late 50s, early 60s, around that time frame. It could be off. So let's actually take a look at each one of these items up close and personal. Let's take a look first at Bugs Bunny. We'll kind of shift these around a little bit so we can get better into these guys. So first off, we're going to take a look at Bugs Bunny. Everything will be up close shots in my light box. He's number 307. Great looking pop. Some sort of side shot here where it says Bugs Bunny. We have this shot right here which says, of course, Bugs Bunny. And the back, which showcases all the actual items in the actual wave. Hit me up in the comment section. This guy right here, the Sylvester and Tweety. I was talking about in the video, should I pick this guy up? I don't know if I really want him or not. I'm not really sold on him and Taz. The four that you see here are the ones I really wanted to get my hands on. So let's take a look at Bugs Bunny number 307 in a pop animation wave. Now he's very, very tall compared to the other ones. He's probably, of course, the tallest character in Looney Tunes. He looks very similar to, let's say, the one that came out for Space Jam, the Michael Jordan movie. They did a Bugs Bunny as well. Very long ears, gray color scheme, sort of white trim on the actual cheeks. He is holding a half-eaten carrot, which I do like. He has a kind of fuzzy tail like we normally see for Bugs Bunny. Big black eyes. There is articulation. Head will spin 360 with no hindrance, and it is not a bobblehead, so I'm very, very happy about that. He will stand sort of. I was messing around with him in the light box. He's very, very back heavy, so you might have a tendency to tip backwards. So just keep that in mind if you're trying to display him out of box for your out of box collectors. You might run into some type of issues with him with standing. He does not have a figure stand, so you cannot plug him into anything, unfortunately. It would have been nice if he would have had a figure stand, but in this situation, he does not have one. So let's actually keep going here. Of course, he was number 307. Let's take a look at his big antagonist, which we well know and love, which of course is Daffy Duck. Much smaller in size and stature because that's what he's portrayed in the actual animation. Sort of the side shot right here, which is of course says Daffy Duck, number 308. This side right here, which is of course a shot of him, and a back shot of all the figures that were available in that particular wave. And of course, he is number 308 in the Pop animation line. Let's take a look at him real quick. As I said before, he's much more squat than, say, Bugs Bunny over here. He's a much shorter character in size and stature, so that's to be expected in a vinyl figure form. Now, there is a bit of hindrance with his finger. He has his finger out in a pose like this. You will get some kind of issues clearing his head, his bill, when you spin his head around. You might rub into the vinyl, so definitely take care. You don't want to sit there and rub back and forth. You don't want to wear the vinyl down, but just take that in consideration when you actually pose the actual figure itself. Of course, he is all black with white eyes, big orange bill, and orange feet. He does have a little black tail in the back here. And again, not a bobblehead. Does have that issue with the finger. Just beware of that when you're posing the actual figure for you out-of-box collectors. Again, he was number 308 in the wave. Now, if you ask me, were these actually ones I had to have? Out of all of them, these two here, which are the Bugs and the Daffy, in my opinion, were not have-to-buy figures. These two were. The episode for Merry Melodies and Looney Tunes, they had one where both Elmer Fudd and Bugs did like an opera, big huge opera piece, an opera set piece, and Elmer Fudd had a Viking helmet on, and he did this gag where he would have a magical spear and helmet, which I talked about at the beginning of the video. You might not have gotten that gag. They did it in the actual cartoon. We'd run around going spear magic helmet. He basically had the powers of Storm from the X-Men. Think of that's that power he had, where he can control storms, he can make it rain, make it lightning. That's what he did in the actual cartoon. It was very, very funny, very, very cool sight gag. Definitely watch the cartoon of the opera if you've not yet seen it. So let's actually get into it here. The Elmer Fudd Pop is number 310. He's the only Elmer Fudd out of the wave. Of course, we have Elmer Fudd listed here. There's the opera on this side. You have a shot of him over here, and of course, the back showcases all the figures were available in the wave, and he is small as well. He's a very, very small body. That was because Elmer Fudd is a very small character when it comes to his size and stature. He's very, very top heavy, big head, very tiny little body. He has this big helmet, very, very big helmet, bigger than his actual head here. It is gray horns, sort of bronze color material on the actual helmet itself. There is a little bit of paint scuff on the back here. Definitely take a look at your figures when you go to purchase them. You want to buy the best possible figure. If they have multiples, look through the lot, see what the best ones they have. You might have some issues in quality control. That is, of course, to be expected with Funko. It looks like the blemish is on right here and on the actual back as well. So it's top here and on the back for this particular Pop. You will have a little clearance issue with the spear here. So definitely take care. There will be some rubbing across the head when you spin it around, but besides that, there's no other hindrance issue. The head does not bobble, so I'm very, very happy about that. I do love the way he looks. He may have some top heavy issues, but he looks okay when he stands. No issues in displaying this particular figure. So I do love the actual Elmer Fudd in his Viking outfit. Very, very funny sight gag. Definitely watch the cartoon if you've never seen it yet. Very traditional animation style. Absolutely love the old pen and art style, the old school animation where they actually would paint a cell and go to the next cell and flip it like a flip book you would see. That's what causes it to give the motion. Very, very cool effect. So I definitely highly recommend the Elmer Fudd from the opera. Love that Pop. Last but not least, we have Bugs Bunny here, which is number 311, which is different Bugs Bunny than this one over here. It's a completely different design, completely different representation of Bugs. Sort of side shot right here, and a shot here of all the all the figures are available in that wave from the Pop animation line, number 311, of course. So let's actually get into Bugs. Now, Bugs here had a big gag in the actual episode of the opera because he dressed up like a woman. I think they called him Broomhilda, which I mentioned at the beginning of the video. I think that's what Elmer here called him or her now, Broomhilda. Bugs has a big Viking sort of Valkyrie helmet here with big wings, basically the same color as the Elmer helmet here. I do love the way he looks. He has sort of the black mascara with the purple eyes at the top here. Very thin body. His body's much smaller than this Bugs over here, this Bugs right here, as far as scale. Now, you will run into some issues here. I was trying to pose it in the light box. He's extremely back heavy and it will tip backwards a lot. You might have to just push the figure down forward to make him stand properly. Now, if you look at the color scheme, very similar to this Bugs here, of course, you have the dark gray, light gray, the purple eyes, like I mentioned before. You have purple trims on the back here of these blonde ponytails that kind of come out from the back of the helmet, and he has a purple dress with sort of a, I would say, like a darker color armored shirt here, I would say. It's sort of like a plate mail base shirt, so it looks really, really good. The arms are clasped behind the back, if you wanted to see here. Definitely you'll see it in my light box, so I highly recommend this one. The episode, if you've never seen it, and if you're in the older generation, if you've never watched that cartoon, definitely watch it. If you're a younger generation, definitely take a look at the old school Looney Tunes. If you've never watched Looney Tunes before, you behoove yourself to actually watch some traditional old school animation. Put Rick and Morty aside, put Family Guy, put Simpsons aside. This is a classic when it comes to animation. I highly recommend the Pop Animation Looney Tune Way Pop 308 for Daffy Duck, 311 for Bugs Bunny from the opera, number 310 Elmer Fudd, and of course 37 traditional Bugs Bunny eating his carrot. I hope you liked this video. Definitely click that subscribe button with a picture of my face. When you click it, you get a little bell notification. Click that notification to be notified of all my newest videos. And last but not least, you can click windows over here to watch more of my content. Take care, guys. I'll see you next video, and bye-bye.